I'm pastor here at the Point Pleasant Presbyterian Church in Point Pleasant Beach, New Jersey. I'm married to Clara Pula, who's also a Presbyterian minister. We have two children, Benjamin and Anya, who are both young adults, one still in college and the other off on his own. I was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin lymphoma in December of 2005. I was diagnosed feeling normal, feeling good, which is why it was such a tremendous shock to get that news, because I wasn't suspecting anything like that. And we needed to treat it rather directly and rather quickly. And that's when life really started to change. The only thing I had was the chemotherapy. It was about a four-month period of time. I had six treatments that were 3 months apart. And thankfully, after having had the chemo, the aggressive component has not come back. What I have now is indolent lymphoma. It's considered incurable but treatable. And I'm very thankful that I'm living at the time that I do now. If this was even 15 years ago, it might have been a very different treatment picture. There's a tremendous amount of resources that are available in the Meridian Health System for treatment. They have PET scans available, both at Jersey Shore and at Ocean Medical Center, which is something that's a real essential in cancer treatment, a focus scan that really can help them identify where there might be areas of concern, hotspots as they call them, where cancer might be cropping up again. I have unfailingly found the staff at Ocean Medical Center to be just wonderful. There's a kind of level of caring and concern that's just very, very real and kind of goes beyond the medical necessities. Cancer, I think, for anyone is a life-changing experience. You get that news and it rocks your world, and life is very, very different afterwards. For me, as somebody who's in a helping profession in ministry, I think it's made me more compassionate. I have a special place in my heart whenever I hear the news that a church member has been diagnosed with cancer, and feel that I come over in kind of a dual capacity, not just as their pastor when I come and visit and talk about what's happened and listen to them, but also share something of my experience and to say, yes, you can get through this, and you will.